So what's going on with this one today?
Today we're going to be doing a hood repair and refinish. Fix these three gouges that are in here. It's going to involve some blending of the clear coat, blending of the paint, a little bit of back taping, and at the very end I'll show you how to wet sand and buff out a blend the proper way. So we're going to start right now with sanding down these gouges that are in here with a little bit of, I'm going to try with the 400 sandpaper on the DA. So this is what it looks like after I've sanded it with 400. I didn't want to go any heavier grit than that, but it is going to need a little Bondo, and I'm probably just going to use some red cap glazing putty to fill that little spot in. Now I sanded that with 400 grit paper on a DA with an interface pad, a soft pad, just so I wouldn't burn any other edges and just stay focused on my damaged area. I did go a little further just to get a good scuff around the area for now.
Now, what is the red cap again?
This is the red cap glazing putty, 3M. You can use any kind of Evercoat, 3M glazing putty. It doesn't matter. It's just a thin coat, because there really wasn't anything left of the gouge, but you know, the thinner you put this stuff on, the easier you're going to be able to sand it, and the quicker it's going to be able to dry. Just let it sit for a little.
You can go ahead.
Okay, what we got James doing right now is the red cap is applied. I like to wet sand my red cap, so that's what he's doing. He's wetting the sandpaper. We're using 600 grit. Take it down as smooth as we can and leave the whatever's going to stay in the gouge, that's what you want to leave in there. And if there's any high spots, you knock them down. Okay, feels good.
Go over it with your hand and see how it feels.
Yeah, you always want to feel it. That feels pretty good. Okay.
Okay.
What I'm doing now, I'm taking a piece of 1500. I'm going to go around where I'm going to do my blend at with my clear coat. I'm going to take it to about right here. I'm sanding right up to this line. It's a small body line on the panel. Or you could do it by hand. I prefer to do this by hand with this being a small area. I don't want to burn any edges with the DA, but if you're careful, you won't burn them. Alright, this is what it should look like after you've sanded for your blend. And since I went over this with 600, I started with 4 and I went to 6. And then took it out with 15, where I'm going to blend my clear somewhere in here and take my clear over to all the way over here and blend it up in here. I won't need any primer because I've taken it down with 6 and then 15. I think it's going to be okay. We'll have to see when we put some paint on. Our next step is going to be back taping this edge and taping off the rest of the area. Yeah. Edge to back tape, but we're going to try it, and if we've got to buff a little bit out, then that's what we'll do. I want to roll it right on the edge. You don't want to have it,
you try to get it right on that body line.
What does back taping prevent?
Back taping prevents you from having a hard line edge from where you're going to do your clear coat. That'll cause it to not have that hard edge there. When you pull this away, there shouldn't be too much of an edge there. And if there is, we'll buff it out.
All right, so...
Got the color made, color's in the gun, reduced. I'm going to start with a light coat, start with the area that I repaired, and try to get that covered first and then blend out from there, and I'll show you what that is. Now, I'm just putting it on light just to see how it's going to cover and see if I'm going to have any blemishes showing up or anything, and it looks like it's covering pretty good. You can give that a minute to kind of pack up, dry. You ready for paint, Biggie? We're gonna give that a minute to dry. And this stuff takes. My second coat of paint on here. I'm just kind of blending it out. I'm not taking it all the way to the end of where I scuffed. I'm going to leave a little to do my clear coat blending. I'm not going all the way up to this line. I'm not going all the way to the fender. I'm stopping a little short. Alright, I got my clear coat made up. Clear and harder mix. I'm about to put my first coat on there. I'm going to put a tack coat on it first. Give it a few minutes to set up and then go with my wet coat. Nice tack coat just to get a little bit on there. Alright, hold up. Alright, we're back to put the wet coat on. The tack coat's sat a couple minutes. Now I'm gonna go with my wet coat. A couple nice even pads. I'm gonna overlap about 50%. And make sure that's going on wet.
Alright. Okay, now what Tom did was he put his wet coat down now. And this is the finish of his sculpt. This is where he's going to do his blend.
He's going to mix in a little bit of reducer, and he's going to take it from old to new and taper it in to when the actual bead is clear. So this is the final step of it. Go ahead.
All right, so I got my reducer in the gun. I've dumped out my clear. I like to leave just, you know, a little bit of clear in the bottom of the cup. Mix it with the reducer, a couple ounces. I shoot my blend old to new. Start old to new. Old clear to new clear. Back and forth until you see it start to shine up. My blend, I'm taking off the back tape. See what I'm left with. You want to pull the back tape off before your clear starts to dry and you can get a little peelage. Alright, now what I'm going to do is let this dry. I'm going to bake it off with a lamp. And then I'm going to come back and wet sand all the debris out, wet sand the blends, wet sand my line here that left a little bit, buff it out. So I'll show you that in a few.
Alright, go ahead.
Here's my heat lamp. I'm going to position the heat lamp to bake this off a little quicker and ensure that the clear is nice and dry before I do my buffing on it.
You don't want to get it too close.
Yeah, you want to keep it about 6 to 8 inches. You want to keep it literally about 12 inches away from your painted surface. Just watch it, just keep an eye on it, because it will bubble the paint.
Watch him. Play yourself. Okay, so that was TC, Thomas Coronado from Out of Paint Plus, showing you how to do a blend on the hood and the steps to it. Stay tuned for more videos. If you have any questions or need any paintwork done, they're located in Hampshire, Illinois. Give TC a call at 847-529-0000 or email him at tccoronado72@gmail.com or go to the web address below. Until then, happy painting.